Welcome to the Melbourne Cricket Ground for this opening match in the VB Series between Australia and New Zealand. First time sponsors of this one-day competition, VB, and we welcome them on board. It's a marvellous product, VB, really a top drop and widely regarded as the brew for you to pull you on through. And as well as the substantial prize money on offer, this very handsome trophy, the Crystal VB Drip Bottle, it's a beautifully crafted piece, this. The VBIV, you see it on your screen there with the Aussie team lining up to top up, and not only a marvellous looking memento for the winners of this series, but a very useful and practical one as well. And one that the Australians, New Zealand and the cricket box from South Africa will all be very keen to step into. Now, the two teams for today's match, firstly Australia. Hayden and Mark Waugh, the openers, Ponting, Gilchrist, Martin, Steve Waugh back in the side under a fitness cloud earlier this week. Still suffering from a bit of that DVT, oi, oi. But has recovered in time to play today. And then Simons, Harvey, Warren, Gillespie and Glenn McGrath. Damien Fleming is the 12th man. And for New Zealand, well, good luck. What a shit-ass looking lineup. Fleming, the skipper, McMillan, Bell, Astle, Perore, Oram, Richardson, sorry, Sinclair, Sulzberger with the lot, Vettori, Tuffy, and the 12th man is O'Connor. Oh, dear me, I'm sorry, everyone. The pitch, though, certainly no laughing matter in these limited overs matches. And here with his report on the condition of the strip and other related matters is AJ Gregg.
Yes, thank you very much, Richie, and I can tell you it's going to be very hard for these players to concentrate and stay focused out here. Stifling conditions, very hot and muggy. The Bureau forecasting 42 degrees here at the MCG today, and this pitch, as you can imagine, very dry and parched. They did put a lot of water on it overnight, the ground staff, but the intense heat throughout the day has seen the pitch dry right up again. Quite a few small cracks starting to appear around the popping crease here. It's also very dusty and quite rough in parts. But the real problems for the batsmen start just a bit further down the pitch, right on a good length, really, and a couple of huge cracks have opened up here, as you can see. They really are some of the biggest cracks I've ever seen in a one-day strip. Now, if we just carefully move over to the edge of this crack here and look down inside, you'll see we've actually been able to install a camera right down inside there.
G'day,
oh,
Danny.
Bloody hell. There's a bloody cameraman in there.
It's me, Joe.
Well, there's one small part of the deal, Rich, that they forgot to inform me about. But bloody hell, I nearly had a heart attack.
Couldn't care less, couldn't give a shit.
Anyhow, that's our new crack cam. Taking a look at our weather wall now, and the current temperature out here in the centre is a scalding 49 degrees. Hardly any breeze to speak of. Humidity 62%. And to gauge the player comfort levels this summer, we've got yet another marvellous innovation we're using throughout this VB series. It's called the scrotometer. Now, here it is. It's only very tiny, as you can see. And it's attached to the player's scrotum with these alligator clips. And the information this little device can give you really is amazing. It gives you moisture content. It has rash-detecting sensors. It measures surface tension, which gives us a reading of the apparent stickiness of the nuts and the inner thighs. And last but not least, the scrotometer also has a built-in microphone that will allow everyone at home to hear firsthand just how sticky and sweaty and squishy it can be down there for the players. Now, just to show you how the scrotometer works, we've got Adam Gilchrist and Mark Waugh, who've been kind enough to come and help us give you a bit of a demonstration. Thanks, fellas.
Yeah,
now, both Mark and Adam are wearing scrotometers. Adam has only just come out of the dressing rooms. He's done no warming up at all. And now, Adam, if you could just go for a short jog for us and we can hear just what this device is picking up. Well, very dry and fresh, really. Sounding very comfortable indeed. Just the gentle rustle of polyester as the player strides out. Now, Mark Waugh, on the other hand, has been warming up here in these very hot conditions for about half an hour or so. Now, Mark, if you wouldn't mind just going for a little jog for us so we can have a listen and compare what the scrotometer is picking up. And, oh, yes, well, a marked difference, as you can hear there. That sounds very squishy and squashy indeed, doesn't it? And you'd have to think that after a couple of hours at the crease or on the field, there's a good chance of developing a nasty rash in some part of the crutch or horse area. And in fact, that noise you just heard there is one of the rash detection sensors going off. So already the early signs of hot, sweaty, pimply, spotty, botty rashes starting to appear on Mark Waugh's arse before this game's even started. Might be time for a quick shower, Mark.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Okay, off you go, and thanks for helping us, fellas.
Cheers, Tay.
So there you are, Rich. It's back to you now in the central missionary position.
Thank you, Tony. Tony Gregg there with his pitch report, and certainly a couple of very interesting pieces of technology there being used for the first time in this VB one-day series. And we'll come back here to the MCG in just a few moments.